So today I want to show you some alterations I made to my Infrasubwoofer. It uses the PowerSoft 30-inch M-Force driver and was originally designed to resonate down to 11 Hz with a really long port, but I want to raise that to 16 Hz. I have a test microphone in front of the driver and port, and another one way over there inside a huge windscreen. So playing pink noise through the sub results in this total frequency response from the mic way over there. Now I cut out a piece of the port that is being replaced by a slab of wood weighed down with some sandbags and a crate because the airflow at the resonant frequency is pretty extreme and would otherwise cause the wood to just vibrate right off of the subwoofer. We can see that if I simply slide the piece of wood back to effectively shorten the total length of the port, the spike in the resonant frequency moves up a bit. But here's the thing, I'm not so much concerned with where the natural spike in the frequency response is, as much as I'm concerned with what frequencies the sub can reproduce with maximum SPL, considering power efficiency combined with excursion. These are all separate things to consider. The driver has a point at which there is minimal excursion, but maximum SPL, considering power consumption, below which the driver begins to excursion a lot and becomes power inefficient for a brief exchange of peak SPL, but immediately followed by an extremely rapid drop in all categories when the phase relationship of the driver and port has already flipped to 180 degrees and they're canceling each other out. For this project, I really want the dip in the driver's response to land at 16 Hz. And right now it's more like 14 Hz. I'll be using it for a digital pipe organ, and the lowest note on the organ is 16.3 Hz, so I want that note to be the last frequency that I can really push the sub hard with and get a lot of SPL before the sub would have to excursion way too much to continue giving me good SPL output. So again, by sliding the piece of wood back and shortening the port length, we can see that dip move upward a bit in frequency to our target of 16 Hz. And in fact, there isn't even really a need to add a high-pass filter to the system below 16 Hz to avoid the over-excursions that would otherwise take place, since there's no content in the digital organ audio signal down there at all, unless they add more stops to the organ. But I'll probably throw one on anyway, maybe 48 dB per octave at like 15.5 Hz. Playing a 16 Hz sine wave shows just how much more SPL we get by shortening the port length. And it may be hard to tell from the video because of the frame rate problem at these frequencies, but the driver doesn't have to work any harder to get the added SPL, which is cool. I also noticed that there were some distortions in the waveform at some frequencies, like 20 Hz here, that got fixed by shortening the port as well. I'm not entirely sure why there was distortion to begin with, or why this fixed it, but I won't complain. If we play a repeating sine wave sweep from 22 Hz down to 16 Hz, we can see the distortions in the waveform that occur with the longer port that largely go away with a shorter port, although not entirely. But then we get a nice SPL bump at the very end, which means we have more headroom at those lowest frequencies, which are the hardest to get to sound as massive as the rest of the organ. This all goes to show how even slight modifications to the physical characteristics of speakers and enclosures can have a really specific and important impact on how they perform. And yes, my neighbors hate me.